Harding, and the challenger, the former champion, Jeff Hitman Harding, is in the ring. All we wait for now is the champion, the old warrior, Dennis Andries, and Andries is ready to come. Andries wears the World Boxing Championship belt around the red robe. It's removed now by the referee, Joe Cortez. There were some complaints from Emmanuel Stewart, the manager of Andries, against this referee, because Joe Cortez is the man who stopped that first championship fight between these two men in Atlantic City. He stopped it in the final round in Harding's favor. So the Andries can complain. But here's the referee, here's our MC, Mike Shinfield.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Gentlemen, this, ladies and gentlemen, is the main event on this evening's program. National Promotions present a light heavyweight contest of 12 3-minute rounds at 12 stone 7 pounds for the WBC Light Heavyweight Championship of the World. Presenting in this corner, ladies and gentlemen, from Australia, the challenger, Jeff Hardy. And from London, ladies and gentlemen, the WBC Light Heavyweight Champion of the World, Dennis Andries. Harding scale 12 stones 5 pounds, Andries 12 stones 7 pounds. The officials for this contest, ladies and gentlemen, the judges, all from the United States, are Carol Castellano, Chuck Hassett, and Thomas Kaczmarek. The referee, also from the United States, Mr. Joe Cortez. The WBC supervisor, Ruben Martinez from Spain, and the timekeeper, Mr. Danny Peacock of England.
And so we're set to go. Andries coming to meet Harding. Andries having tonight his ninth world championship fight. And on top of those, there have been another seven involving either the British or the European championship. Des Lynam mentioned an ex-certificate. He may not be far wrong. The two previous fights were wars. The decider between Andries of Britain and Harding of Australia. And Andries goes straight to work, head down, clubbing the punches across. There's no finesse with Dennis. In his most recent fight, the Australian beat an American called Bobby Jennings in 7 rounds, but at the same time, he sustained a cut, and that cut was over the left eye. That was in June. It's had 3 months to heal. Two previous fights had explosive endings and were very similar in the way that they went. In the first one, Andries looked all over a winner and then got stopped in the final round. In the second, it looked as though Harding might well win it, and then he came to grief in the seventh. Andries these days, of course, fights out of Detroit. He belongs to that famous fight camp in Detroit, the Kronk stable, run by Emanuel Stewart. The camp from which Tommy Hearns comes, a man that Andries once fought and wants to fight again. And the punches are raining in on Harding in these opening moments. The Australian already is feeling the weight of the champion's blows. Savage clubbing punches, the only way Andries knows how to fight. And this is just the sort of stuff their two previous fights were made of. And Harding is going to have a job to weather this early storm. Well, how's that for an opening 3 minutes of a world title fight? They can't keep that up for 12 rounds. That is absolutely certain. Andries, very, very close indeed to his 40th birthday, although some people try to tell you he's 37. My opinion is he'll be 40 in November. Here's some of the action from that explosive opening round, with Andries tossing everything at the hitman. The hitman was being hit. He did well to get out of this situation on the ropes. I'm not so sure he got out of it himself. I think he was helped on his way by the right.
Corner, 10 seconds.
To the champion, Dennis Andries, born in Guyana, brought to London when he was a child and brought up in Hackney in the East End of London, and now a citizen of Detroit. And Harding, who came from the outback of New South Wales and worked his way up from beach bum to world boxing champion. Socking right hands extremely well. Sound of Andries' punches can be heard thudding into the body of Harding. Andries expending a lot of energy in these opening two rounds so far. Harding has shown no signs of going down. Tremendous punches being thrown by Andries. And Harding amazingly standing up to them. Who for two rounds now has taken just about every good punch Andries can throw, and already he's suffering a little bit on that left eye, which is the one I told you was cut in June against the American Bobby Jennings, and it is slightly cut, and the right eye as well is looking a little damaged. So although his heart is strong and his body is strong, the eyes quite clearly are weak. Here's some more of that pulverizing action from Andries. Look at that. Now that's the sort of punch you would expect to knock a man out with. And Harding hardly shook.
Corner, 10 seconds. Take it up. Round three.
So two rounds very clearly in the champion's pocket. But the challenger still upright. Harding, 26, 13 years younger. 21 fights behind him. Just the one defeat, the one he suffered against Andries, when Andries got his world title back. In fact, Andries has won this world light heavyweight title 3 times in all, a record for any British fighter. Hardly seems possible that in the early stages of his career, I used to watch Dennis Andries trying and failing to win the British title. His career has turned into a real Indian summer. Himself now beginning to do a little scoring inside. Quite sharp, short punches finding their way into the body of the champion. Is going to end with one of them dropping, but which one? It hasn't got him very far, except he may well have the first 3 rounds on the card. Well, it's an amazing record this man has. He's been around so long. He's been a pro since 1978, and tonight he marks up the half century in professional fights. Well, he's fighting tonight in the Hammersmith Odeon, but some of the punches that Dennis throws seem to start somewhere out in the Fulham Palace Road.
Corner, 10 seconds.
The WBC Light Heavyweight Championship. Andries the champion. Harding, who's come to get his old title back. And now the Australian tries to move into the attack against this steamroller called Andries. By sheer strength, Andries drives his man back. Continues to soak up this extraordinary barrage and continues to fight back. You're getting a graphic illustration here of just how fit you need to be a champion fighter. The spray of water off the head of Harding as these punches lash in at him again. Insists on fighting back. You don't see too many fights like this. Quickly indeed when the bell goes, determined to get as much rest as he can. The face beginning to disintegrate. Just that one defeat from Andries, a man who made very quick progress to the top after he turned pro. And both sides of his face badly marked. But as far as I can see, not much blood coming from either eye. Hardly a mark on the champion. But he's done a lot of work.
Corner 10 seconds.
Saw Harding at the Edinburgh Commonwealth Games in 1986 when he was a middleweight. He beat a Welshman and a Northern Irishman, but in the final he lost on points to England's Rob Douglas. These two men had their first fight 2 years ago in Atlantic City, and Andries was way ahead in the 12th and final round, when exhaustion got to him and Harding stopped him. They had the return in Melbourne and Harding looked like winning it until Andries punched him out of it in the 7th. Now Andries is well ahead, but has he got the fight won? Amazingly enough, Harding almost seems to be getting stronger. And Andries is beginning not to throw quite so many punches. Good right hand from Harding. This is the best round he's had so far. And Harding, the challenger, for the first time perhaps in this fight, has landed more punches in this round than Andries. Typical Andries onslaught, like those we saw in the first three rounds, coming at Harding again. And yet, the Australian still has not been on the floor. really now a question of whose determination gives way first. Whatever happens in this fight, we will have to admire the sheer courage and the willpower of this Australian, Jeff Harding, because he really has been under the most extraordinary barrage of punches from the first bell. And yet, in that last round, he began to come back at Andries, and in fact gave Andries a lot of trouble. So it's far from over. Andries ahead, but maybe Harding is catching up.
Only 10 seconds. Pick it up. Round six.
And it's Harding this time who moves straight into the attack. 5 savage rounds behind us and nothing decided. Andries, the old warrior, close to 40, but now it's quite clear he's going to have to dig down into the deepest reserves of his strength and courage in this fight if he wants to win it, because Harding appears to have plenty left. Faster punches now coming from the Australian. And Andries now only throwing the occasional punch. And Harding in this round, quite clearly throwing the better quality punches. But where he's found the strength from to do it, I don't know. And it's Andrew's turn to soak it up now as he drives forward and walks on to punishment. These two men testing each other's courage to the limit. The Andries gun shield now stained red. And that was quite clearly Harding's run. Now there might be anxiety in the Detroit corner. Emmanuel Stewart in front of Dennis Andries. Andries now will need some encouragement. He'll need some help from that corner. Because despite everything he's done, the fight seems to be slowly turning against him. And Harding was pumping in a lot of good punches in that last round, the sixth. We're working, one suspects, to an extraordinary climax.
Round and seven.
And for two rounds now, the challenger, Jeff Harding from Australia, has slowly whittled away at the early lead that Andries set up. With those early rounds full of savage punching. We're in the second half now of this scheduled 12 roundup with Andries' WBC title at stake. Andries, the Rock, as he's known these days, or as some people say in reference to his age, Rock of Ages. And Harding has a confident look about him. Andries still trying to drive forward, but taking more than he's giving. Andries again finds strength from somewhere and tries once again to club this stubborn Australian into the floor, and he still can't do it. A sign of Andries' strength. Once this man began to get on top, so Andries turned the tables yet again. And one wonders just how much strength and resistance there's left in this extraordinary Australian, Jeff Harding, from New South Wales. Our bird's eye camera showing Harding getting the better of it in this exchange quite clearly.
Corner 10 seconds.
So five rounds to go if it should get that far. And it doesn't seem possible. Sort of courage to stand up and continue in a fight like this. Frank Bruno is sitting ringside here, a man who's thinking of making a comeback. When we looked at this, he might decide it's too tough a game after all. Quite amazing, the way it swings from one man to the other. Harding's had his fling in this round. Now Andres beginning to get back at him. Expertise, you won't find too much of it in this fight, but you'll find plenty of courage and willpower and determination, sheer guts from both men. Bleeding a little. That's the least of his problems. This time, one on the belt from Harding. And Andries, what goes through his mind, I wonder, in a fight like this, when he's thrown everything he can, and he's hit the man so hard and so often, and the opponent, this man, has not once been on the floor or even looked like going there. But he is suffering around the eyes. Andries, he's got one or two nicks appearing now. But considering what he's been through, Andries has remarkable little damage. This was a good attack towards the end by Harding.
Cornish 10 seconds. Check it out. Round nine.
A very, very tough defense indeed of his title here by Andries. And it's by no means certain yet that he's going to keep his title. Considering the way their last two fights ended, you really don't know what to expect. Continue slogging and slugging. Neither man willing to give way. Exhaustion now must surely be creeping into both of them. We're in the ninth.
his head. Good right hand, a short right hand from Harding as he came off the ropes. Still full of fight. Andries now, his mouth badly hurt. Andries almost blindly throwing punches. And Andries on very unsteady legs, I may say. Finds himself conveniently near his corner. His eyes are beginning to look quite damaged now, Andries. They're beginning to close a little. And he's beginning to look to me to be in the first stages of real exhaustion. And there are still three rounds to go. Is this going to be a repeat of their first battle in Atlantic City, when Andries seemed to have it won and then lost it in the 12th? Well, Andries got caution for his head in that round, illegal use of it. We might just see what happened. There it was. Look at that. That was, well, I won't say a deliberate butt, but it was as near to it as you'll get.
Corner 10 seconds.
Still one has to ask, who will crack first? And this crowd now singing its encouragement to Andries. But it seems to me the going gets harder by the moment for the champion. Harding still looks quite capable of putting together good combinations. Andries now actually attempting to box behind the jab. These men certainly the two most durable light heavyweights in the world at the current time, and they've staged a fight of extraordinary severity and bravery here in Hammersmith tonight, and you're watching it live. Top and stay there. Off his feet with the ferocity of the right hand. And so the tenth comes to the end, and every round seems to be quite amazing. Two to go now. And Harding, who you might have felt would have been swept out of this fight in the first two or three rounds under the sheer ferocity of the attack, is still there, and he survived the cuts and bruises, and he's still capable of taking this title. And no matter what Andries does, he cannot subdue him. The moment you think Andries is on top, this is what happens. And so, if he goes all the way, they have another 6 minutes to stand toe-to-toe and fight it out. Well, at this point, I have Andries a couple of points ahead, but it's not over. Getting very vociferous, which is a sure sign of anxiety, urging the man on. And Andries once again tossing everything towards the Australian, but Harding will not give up, and he won't back off. The 11th round, and the savagery of this extraordinary contest continues. Does Andries sense some weakness in Harding at this point? Seen anything like it. And Joe Cortez now has to drag them apart because they're lying on each other in exhaustion. I don't think the pair of them really know what they're doing at this stage, except they know they mustn't go down. An unbelievable desperation in Andries' work as he tries to subdue this obdurate challenger. And Harding won't be beaten. Andries is throwing punches, I think, out of instinct. Could hardly lift himself off the ropes to find his way back to the corner, and still neither man has been down in this most extraordinary of fights. And Andries desperately trying to finish it there and then. He hasn't done it, and there's still 3 minutes to fight, and Harding looks the fresher. So these two men here tonight in Hammersmith have put up a most wonderful fight. Every courageous aspect shown here by these two men, neither of whom is willing to give way. It's not pretty to watch, but the bravery is admirable. Crowd here in this cinema rise to the two men. They clap their hands above their heads as the two of them go off into the final 3 minutes. Will one of them be heading for oblivion? It could be. And you still don't know quite what is going to happen. Andrews the champion, Harding the challenger. A fight to the finish. He was out on his feet. These great sliding punches from Andries come at him again. Moves away from the ropes and instantly comes back into the attack. And that has been round after round. And some 3,000 people here now trying to cheer Andries to victory. But a victory which isn't quite there yet. We have 1 minute left. I think Andries is out on his feet again, just as he was 2 years ago. But from somewhere deep down, he finds some punches to throw. I haven't seen too many fights like this. We're in the last 30 seconds. And they can't stop throwing punches at each other. It's been like that for 12 rounds. 12 amazing rounds. A world title fight. We'll always remember. There won't be a knockout now. It's all over. And it goes to the judges. And these two men have given each other the most extraordinary fight. And Harding is shouting his head off, hoping to celebrate victory, but I'm not so sure. I make Andries a narrow winner. But three judges will decide it. One of them is a woman, Carol Castellano from the States. They're all from the States, Chuck Hassett and Thomas Kaczmarek. They're the three judges who will decide. The referee takes no part in the scoring. But this place now, in a state of extraordinary excitement. Well, you don't see too many fights like that. And I must say, in the last two rounds, there were moments when I thought Andries might go. He seemed to me to be fighting at one stage purely on instinct. But Harding couldn't find the punches to subdue him any more than Andries could find them to beat him. Andries quite certainly set up a good early lead. It was whittled away a little in the middle rounds. And then Andries came back again at about the two-thirds mark. And Harding made a late finish. Close, but I still have Andries ahead. A lot of it, of course, will depend on just how the judges felt the punches had landed Harding at times was certainly landing better quality punches, and Andrews was swinging a lot, but a lot of the punches were missing. So this verdict awaited with keen interest, and Harding is already proclaiming victory and getting a respectful cheer.
Now, gentlemen, please.
Here's the result.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a split decision.
Well, it is close. It's a split decision.
Judge Carol Castellano scored the contest 114-140. Judge Thomas Kaczmarek scores the contest 115-113. Judge Chuck Hassett scores the contest 115-114 for the winner and the new W.
And Harding has got it. For the second time, Jeff Harding gets a narrow decision and wins the title from Andries. Andries got a draw on one card and lost the other two decisions by 2 points and 1 point. So, for the third time in his life, Dennis Andries loses the light heavyweight crown, and Harding regains it. And Harding avenges the only defeat on his professional record. But Andries, coming up close to 40 years old, he's won the title 3 times, he's lost it 3 times. Will he, I wonder, call it a day now? What a fight that was, but he couldn't make it stick on the judges' cards. And so we have a new light heavyweight champion of the world, and he's going to be interviewed by Jim Neely.
Jeff, many congratulations. You've got the title back. How did that fight compare with the first two?
Well, it was just as hard, and I'll have to say that I got into Dennis's fight there in the final. I started out to come out to be more elusive and just get away and get behind the jab. I did in a couple of rounds, but therefore I fought his fight. But, you know, he's a warrior, and you know, it was a hard fight. I knew it was going to be a war, and you know, I'm just happy to be champion again, and I have to take my hat off to Dennis. He's a great champion.
The first 3 or 4 rounds, he really just about threw everything at you.
Yeah, well, I knew he was going to come out blazing, because he always does. And the thing is with Dennis, he's a hard man, and he's a freak at his age. Whatever age he is, it don't really matter. He's as fit as a 25-year-old, and that's all that counts.
Dennis, you must be bitterly disappointed losing your title once again to this man.
Yeah, I'm disappointed. Damn.
Was it that close?
Well, it was a split decision, but I think what everybody would like to know, are we going to have Harding Andries number 4?
Well, I think I got to talk to my manager, and we'll see where we go from here.
Commiserations, and I think very much congratulations to the champion. Well done, Jeff.
Thanks very much, and I'd like to thank my dietitian who is responsible for this win, Helen O'Connor. I owe you a big kiss, mother, when I get back. All right!
Well done.